Hey guys, so today I'm going to show you how to make a Dutch braid, and I'm actually going to do two Dutch braids in my hair. So the first thing I'm going to do is comb my hair and make a part, and I usually part my hair on the side right there, but because I don't want my two braids to be completely different sizes, I'm going to make the back part in the middle, and this will just help even all the hair out. So I'm going to split my hair into two and tie one side off with a hair tie just to get it out of the way. It makes it a lot easier to do this. So next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take the front section, about an inch of hair, and I'm going to split it into three pieces. And I'm going to take the piece that's closest to my face first, and I'm going to tuck it underneath the middle piece, and then I'm going to take the back piece that's farthest away from my face and tuck it under what is now the middle piece, and I'm going to just continue this kind of pattern, and each time I'm going to add a little bit more hair to the strands. So the main difference between a Dutch braid and a French braid is that with a French braid, each strand is getting passed over the middle strand, and with a Dutch braid, each strand is getting passed under the middle strand, and that results in a braid that looks like it's sitting on top of the head instead of what you would normally see with a French braid, and you'll be able to see that here in a minute. A good rule of thumb with braiding, any kind of braiding actually, is the braid is going to go wherever I put my hands. So if I want my braid to sit lower, kind of along my hairline, above my ear, that's where I'm going to put my hands, and that's where I'm going to drag all of the hair to. But if I wanted the braid to sit up higher on my head, I would put my hands up higher. Braid all the way down, and I'm going to tie it off with a hair tie. As you can see, I left a piece of hair out by accident, and that happens sometimes when you have short hair. I went back and fixed it later on. So I went ahead and did my other braid off camera, and my last step, this is optional, I really like my braids to look nice and wide and a little bit messy, so I actually go and I tug at each plait all the way down. I just kind of stretch them out and loosen them a little bit. This just gives the appearance of more hair, and I have really short hair right now, so I like the way that looks. So that's pretty much it. I went ahead and pinned these braids up in the back at the end after I stopped filming. So you can do a lot of fun things with these braids. I really like the way they look. So anyway, hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Bye.